not gonna be some random creeper jumping out behind a bush. It's gonna be someone you know that doesn't understand, because you're both incapacitated, or not because you're both drunk, that you don't understand what no, he doesn't understand what no means, and you can't even understand what he's mean. So what happens, not all the time, but sometimes, because what with sexual assaults happens sometimes is they got this male, there's a male that's drinking, his judgment is impaired, so he thinks what he's doing is okay. And then you got young women whose judgment that's impaired. She's thinking he should know this is not okay. And then the next morning, the next day, they wake up like, what happened last night? And he's like, well, everything was okay. You said this is okay. You said it's okay. And she's like, I don't remember anything. It's two lives ruined. All because people just don't want to take the time to say no to alcohol. Like, hands down. Like, it is the easiest thing to avoid. It's like texting and driving. You can easily avoid the car crash if you put the phone down. You can easily avoid the heartache and pain if you just put the alcohol down. Like, just wait till you're 21. Literally, just wait. You have all the life to live of buying alcohol after you turn 21. But people just think, I gotta get it now, I gotta get this experience. What am I missing? You're not really missing anything. You're really not. Besides seeing my face and then telling me whatever story that I'm looking like. Oh, okay. It just magically appeared just right in your hand. Did it just walk on, like, it, did it just grow feet and walk up your leg and just jump in your mouth? Okay. So, before you take the time to hear someone that says, oh, yeah, partying this, partying that. First of all, I tell you, we have 56,000 students on this campus. 56,000. And people actually believe everybody drinks. So I asked the student, how much alcohol do you think you would need to supply 56,000 students? He was like, well, I mean, you have Walmart, you have the little drive. I was like, look, if 56,000 people took even a shot or two on one Friday night, there would be a dry, there would be no alcohol in the 5 mile radius of this place. It's not possible. But again, the idea is that everybody does it because everybody around me is doing it. So I tell you, do not, and this statistic, is this not an ASU? It's not just within, it's a nationwide. Nationwide. No matter where you go. First day of class and say, Dr. So-and-so, because they're going to be a doctor. Dr. So-and-so, whatever, Dr. Tony Clark. I can't attend your office hours. Is there the possibility that we can either schedule a meeting or where you can kind of, just in case I need assistance, where can I go? Because you want that professor to know that you're automatically going to need assistance, just in case. So it's not something at the end of the middle of the semester, you emailing him or her that, I don't understand. You already had that groundwork, that foundation. And most professors are going to be like, oh yeah, you know, well, tell me when you can meet and we'll set something up. That's literally what happened. But you'd be surprised how many students just walk by. And as soon as you make that connection, so it's like, Joshua, I know you now. So I look at Josh, I see your grade. Who is Joshua? I know Josh, the Penguin of Wall Street. I see Josh is hovering over a C plus or a B minus. I'm gonna give it a B minus. Yeah, because I kind of like Josh, right? And that's literally what happens, literally. Because some professors, if they know you, they'll bump you up. Some professors, if they don't know you, they're like, you get what you get. So sometimes it behooves you. And all of you that wanna go to med school, medical program, psychology, you're gonna need to do what's called a research assistantship. And who do you think you're going to do a research assistantship with?
Professor.
A professor. Because all your professors are going to be nationally known, world-renowned researchers. And what better way to get in if you got 4 years of being with this researcher? So when you do graduate, you apply for that med school or that program, you could put on your application, I studied with this person with this research. So my wife graduated from college with a biology degree, and under it she was published in three different magazines. Three different articles were published because she worked with a professor who was working on cancer and how to re-engineer a cell to recognize it. So if my wife ever wanted to go to med school, she could say I was published in three different articles. If you have any questions, one, no one tells you about heartache and pain. So when you're in college and you're dating someone and you think this person is going to be the right person for you and you get your heart broke, believe me, it is a learning experience. It sucks while you're in the moment. It's terrible, right? But it is something that you have to be able to understand that as a learning process. And that, you know, I know it's gonna sound cliche and like so Shakespearean, it's better to have loved than not have loved at all. Because you're gonna grow from it. You're gonna understand what that means. You're gonna understand how that process kind of goes. And another reason why it sucks is because you're gonna be away from your support system. It's kind of like catching the flu the first time away from home. And you gotta call your mom and be like, Mom, what am I doing? I'm sick. She gonna look at you like, you better go to the health clinic. And you're like, it's so far away. I gotta walk there by myself. You're gonna revert back to a 4-year-old. Because there's gonna be nobody here to help you. But that's also the process of being in college. Does that make sense? No questions. Y'all ready to go to college? Yeah.
Alright, so I'm kind of like at a dilemma. So I might be getting like a full ride for wrestling for college. Does that take up a lot of time in college?
Yes. Being a student athlete, they're going to manage your time. So you don't have to worry about having time. It's going to be managed. What institution do you want to be asking?
It's just Johnson & Wales, Silver Lining.
Yeah, so they're going to pretty much kind of tell you where to be, when to go, when to rehab, when to study hall. I mean, it's going to be a lot easier for you. I don't know the reason why I know that, because I work with student athletes.
Should they have a hard time?
What?
With their time on?
No, because he'll have tutors. So he'll have tutors, he'll have a specific academic coach. Well, it depends on how big the school is.